हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक क्लास 11। टुडे आई एम अगेन रिवाइज अवर चैप्टर 3 पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग बेसिक। सो टुडे एंड अवर सबसिक्वेंट चैप्टर आई वांट टू फोकस ऑन ओनली प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट। ओके, सो टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग अवर पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग रूल्स। सो प्रैक्टिकली वी कैन से वन बाय वन थिंग। सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज वेरिएबल आर नॉट स्टोरेज कंटेनर इन पाइथन। ओके, सो वी कैन से, सो हियर आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस दिस पॉइंट, सो मिनिमाइज दिस थिंग एंड वी कैन, दिस इज अवर पाइथन सॉफ्टवेयर यू कैन सी। सो आई वॉन्ट टू डबल क्लिक। ओके स्टूडेंट, सो आई वॉन्ट टू डबल क्लिक एंड दिस इज अवर पाइथन इंटरफेस। नाउ यू कैन चेंज द फॉन्ट, यू कैन क्लिक ऑन ऑप्शन, देन यू क्लिक ऑन कन्फ्यूगर IDLE. Then you can select Arial Unicode and you can see the size 22 and you can select bold. Arial 22 and bold, then click apply and then you can OK. Now here I am using file and new. Okay, so now you can save this file. First you save this file. So here I am saving this file D drive and here I am using trial 1. Okay, so I want to save this file. So our first point is, you can say, we can say variables are not storage container in Python. Okay, so what is the meaning is, suppose when you type a is equal to 3, this a is every variable, a is variable, 3 is value, and b is equal to 4. Okay, when you print a and when you print b, okay, first you save this file and run this program. Okay students, now you can see the value of a, you can see one by one the value of a, you can see this is our 3 and this is our 4. Okay, simply we a and b, this is our variable and we can display the value of variable a and b variable 4. But a is equal to 3, okay, so a is variable, the value is 3, but the memory address we can say 1001. When the value a store you in value 4, so you can see the memory address remains same, memory address is remain same, but value change. Okay, so this is not a Python language, this is in C, C++, Java, so memory address will not change, only value change. But in Python you can see the new thing is here memory address 1001, but here memory address is 1005. So in Python memory address always change. Okay, value also change, this is okay, but memory address also change. So we can say each time you can change the value of a variable and memory address also change, memory address also change inside the memory. Okay, so we can say variable are not a storage container. So every time you can change the value of a and you can see the result. Now you can see here I am using the Python. Okay, here I am using the again the a. Okay, we can use print a. Okay, again I am printing the print a. Okay students, now I want to save this file and run this program again. Now you can see the output, again you can see 3 and 4. So output is same, first it will display 3, then it will display 4. But I want to remove this a simply. Now you can see the a is 3, a is 4. Now I want to save this file and run this program. So what is the output? You can see only 4 because the last value of a is 4. Okay, because 3 is replaced by 4. Now next point, you can see L value and R value. Okay, so in Python we can use A is equal to 20, B is equal to 10, B is equal to A plus 3. So variable must be in left side and value always in right side. So this will give the error. When you use value then variable, so it will give the error. We must use variable left side. Okay, so here I am giving the example, simple example you can see. So here I am change the, here I am using 3 is equal to 4, 3 is equal to a, here I'm using 4 is equal to A. Now you want to save this program and run this program again. Now you can see this gives the error, syntax error, cannot assign to literal because variable always in left side. So we can use A, then we can use 3. Okay, so we can use any example, but variable must be in left side and value in also in right side. So this concept we can say this is our L value and R value. Okay, so we can say expression are always because in L value we know your expression always in left side in general mathematics, but in Python this is the right way. Okay, this is the right way. Okay, so variable always in left side and value always in right side. If you use this style, it will give the error. Now multiple assignment concept. Okay, suppose you have A, B, C. Okay, control C, and here I am using again control V. Now you can see A is 10, B is 10, C is 10. Now all the value have same value. Now here I am using print A, here I am using print B, here I am using print C. So what is the output of this code? I want to save and run this program. So you can see the output 10, 10, 10. But you can see here value is same. Here value is same. So we can directly use same line we can use in this style. A is equal to B is equal to C is equal to 10. I want to save and run this program. So you can see 10, 10, 10. So this is our shortcut because value is same. So we directly use in single line. So this same thing we can use in this style. In this style we can use. Okay, because value is same, so we can write in one line also. We can also write in separately, we can also use. But when we have this different values, when we have different values, so in different value we can use, suppose here I want to use, so you can see A had 10, B have 20, C have 30, I want to save and run this program. Now you can see 10, 20, 30, but here value is completely different. So we can use our, so same thing we can use A, B, C. Here I am using 10, 20, 30. So same instruction we can write in this style. A for 10, B for 20 and C for 30. So in one line we can also use the same instruction. So I want to save and run this program again. Now you can see the output 10, 20, 30. Okay, student. So when we have a different value, we can use comma. When we have same value, we can use equal to. So multiple assignment we can use. Now we can use swapping the value. We can use swapping the values. Suppose interchange the value. Suppose we can, here I am using, suppose here I am using A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20. But I want to interchange the value. A become hold 20 and B become hold 10. So here I am using a third variable t is equal to A, t is equal to A, and A is equal to B, and B is equal to t. Okay, t, this is our t. So here I am using print A and here I am using print B. Now I am save this file and run this program. Now you can see the output. You can see now A have 20, A have output in 20, you can see 20, and B have 10. Okay, now you can see the output. So the value of A have 20, the value of B have 10. So we can interchange the value, but here we can use the third variable T. We must copy the value of A in advance in T variable, then we can assign B value in A. Then the copy value of T, value of A, which already in T variable, we can use the in B variable. But in Python is a great facility. We directly use, we cannot use the T variable, third variable T. We directly assign. We can directly interchange the value in one line. Because T variable, there is no need. Okay, in Python we directly use this style, okay, to interchange the value. So we can use A comma B is equal to B comma A. So in this single line statement in Python, there is no need to use t. Okay, so directly we can interchange the value. You can see save and run this program again. Now you can see the output 10, 20 and 10. Now A have 20, B have 10. So in Python, we directly use in single line. So there is no need to use t variable. Okay, we can directly use interchange the value in single line. So A, the value of B will store in A, the value of A will store in value B. Now next rule is Python first evaluate RHS and it will assign the in LHS variable. Okay, so this thing you can see A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2 and C is equal to 3. So here I am using the practical example. So you can see here I am using this example. Okay, so you can see here I am using A is equal to 1, okay, B is equal to 2, C is equal to 3. Okay, but here I am using A is equal to A plus 4. So you can see A value is 1, so 1 plus 4 it will give 5. So you can see 5. Now here I am using C is equal to B plus 5. So what is the last value of B? You can see 5. So 5 plus 5 10. Now C is 10. Now here I am using C, A is equal to C minus 6. So what is the last value of C? You can see 10. So 10 minus 6, you can see 4. Okay, now you can use print A, we can use print B. Okay, now we can use print C to see the output. Now A will print 4, B will print 5, C will print 10. I want to save and run this program. So you can see here one by one instruction will execute A 4, B 5 and 10. Okay, so here one by one instruction will use. So last value of B will use here, the last value of C will use here. So here there is no broadcasting, one by one it will execute. But in Python, so same instruction we will write in one line. Okay, so same instruction we can use in one line. Here using B, C, A. Here I am using A plus 4. Okay, here I am using B plus 5. Here I am using C minus 6. So here one thing to keep in mind, here last value of A is 1. So you can see 1 plus 4, 5. Now B, so last value of B you can see 2, 2 plus 5, 7. C, last value of C is 3 minus 6, so you can see minus 3. So B hold 5, C hold 7 and A hold minus 3. So now you can see the output. So here broadcast the value. Broadcast means the A will supply here, B will supply here and C will supply here. So here last value of B, C, A variable will not use, but here one by one execute, so it will use. Okay, but here broadcast the value. Okay, you can see the internal explanation. So here output will different. Okay student, so I want to save and run this program again. Now you can see the output minus 3, 5 and 7. Okay, so when you write in one line, so you must use broadcast, okay, in this style directly. So last value of B, C, A in next instruction will not use in not broadcast values. Okay students, now next concept of Python is dynamic binding when you use variable. So you can see here I am using this example. Okay, so now you can see A is equal to 5, A is equal to 10. Now the last value of A is 10. Here I am using B is equal to A divide 2. Here I am using print B. So what is the output? You can see A 5. Now A is 10. Now A is 10. So 10 upon 2 it will give 5. So it will give 5. I want to save and run this program. Now you can see this is our output 5.0. Okay students. Now this is not a dynamic. This is without dynamic. But here A is 5. This is number. And in variable there is a number, but here I am using another thing. Here I am using Python. Now you can see last time A have number, but right now A have the string data, Python. So A means Python upon 2. So it is not possible. It is not possible because a string value and number value cannot be divided. So I want to save and run this program. So you can see it will give the error. unsupported operand. Okay, so str means this is a Python data, so Python value cannot divide by 2. Okay, so in Python provide a dynamic binding, this is a good facility, but when you use mismatch data type, so it will give the error. Okay, it will give the error. Now next thing is variable definition. So there is a next concept is variable definition. Suppose directly here I am using print a and I want to save and run this program. So you can see it will give again variable a is not defined, means what is the value of a, so Python will not recognize. So first you assign a value, any value must be assigned. Suppose here I am using 90. Okay, so first you assign the value, then you can use printing calculation. Okay, then Python will not give any kind of error because we already give the value of a is 90. So clearly we must assign a value, then we can print or we can use in calculation. Directly you can use print, so it will give the error. So we must use assign a value, then we can use in printing, otherwise it will give the error in this style. So variable definition. Now you can see to display value, memory address and data type. Okay, so you can see a is equal to 3. So here I am giving one example. Suppose here I am using a is equal to 3. Suppose I want to save this program and run this program. So you can see, so Python will display 3. Okay, so we know very well. Now suppose I want to see the memory address, so simply we can use print. Okay, but here we can use id function, we can use this id function. So id function will not give 3, it will give the memory address of a. So I want to save this and run this program. Now this time you can see a value of a is 3, but this is our memory address of variable a. So we can see the memory address using the id variable. Now what, this is a number, so I want to see the data type of variable a. So we can use type function. So simply we can use print here I am using type function. Okay, and a. So you can see this time we can save this program and run this program again. Now you can see first time it will display a, the memory address. Okay, and this will give the, this is a number, this is an integer. Okay, so when you use type, so nature of a is this is an integer. When you use id, it will give the memory address, and we simply we can use the a, so it will give the value. So we can use three kind of information: variable value, variable memory address, and we can also the nature of this variable. Suppose here I am using 3.5. I want to save and run this program again. Now this time you can see it will give 3.5 memory address, but this time it will give float. It will give float because this is a point value. Now here I am using Raj. I want to, so this is a string, so I want to save and run this program again. Now you can see this time Raj, but here it will give str. Str means this is a string. Okay students, so this is again Python variable rules. Now so today I am discussing varied kind of variable rules of Python. Okay, so you keep in this rule in mind. Okay, so first I have discussed about so Python use always different memory location. When you change the value, so always use different memory location. Okay, we always use variable in left side and variable always and value always in right side. Okay, this is the right way. Okay, when you have same value, so we can also use this style, is equal to style we can use. When you have different values, so we can use comma style, in one line we can use. When you want to interchange the value, so Python provide a great facility, we directly use a comma b and b comma a. So directly we can interchange the value, there is no need to use third variable t in Python. In Python, we can use one by one expression evaluation. So last value of B, last value of C will evaluate in next instructions. But here we can use in same line also. But here there is no last value we'll use. Here the broadcast the value in this style directly, then it will calculate, then it will assign one by one. Now we can use dynamic binding, we can change the data type, but when you use misspaced data type, so it will give the error. We must assign a value, then we can use printing. We directly we cannot use because it will give the error. Okay, now any variable have three things. We can display the value, we can see the memory address, we can also see the data type. Okay, which kind of value a variable have. So okay students, thank you so much.